Hello, I'm Satoshi Yamamoto. Welcome back to my time bench. Okay, today I'm going to do a damselfly, damsel nymph that I just come up with. Damselfly, this is apparently for spring creeks, ponds and lakes around here with a great success. It's a very soft material here. I'm going to use Marabou and Aftershaft, and then Chickabou, so M-A-C, so I'd like to call it Mac Damsel, and then it's really soft, probably the softest and the most undulating, you know, damsel nymph pattern in the market. And then of course, well, it catches fish, and then so it's really simple to tie and fun to tie. So let's get started. Hook I'm going to use is Daiwiki 280 from size 8 to down to 14. This is 12, just about a medium size, and then thread I'm going to use is either olive or olive down. Again, either 6-0 or 8-0. I'm going to use 8-0 here. And I'm not going to add a weight lead wire, so I will explain how to fish later on. Okay, attach thread here. I'm gonna stop just above the bob. Bob is not really showing here. Here you go. Okay, first Chickabou is like almost like a marabou, but the reason I like some tires, you know, really picky about Chickabou is I believe, at least my case, you know, it's a shape, it's kind of really square, you know. Of course, it's gonna be really one thing, you know, hair, you know, when it gets wet. Anyway, I like to attach this back to back. You know, back to back. I measure just about a hook shank length, or maybe almost entire hook length. Just about here. Hold that. I don't really lap whole thing with this, why? Because I don't have to. Okay, I'm going to add the gold wire medium. This is somewhat, you know, weight, but it's more like a protection, which protection for the next material. This one I just wrap and secure very tightly here. Just one fiber here. You know, I don't think it matters whether you tie this wire first, then tying tail next. Doesn't really matter. Okay, I'm just kind of even trying to even up around here. Then, after shaft. Well, you can find aftershaft from, you know, pheasant, pretty much any birds, you know. I think this might be from partridge. And then some, you know, from some dyed cape or saddle or whichever. Once in a while you find this kind of, you know, olive, you know, dyed, you know, aftershaft. But size kind of varies, but I'd like to demonstrate one thing. So I just use this medium size here, tying from the kind of butt end here. Okay. Just going forward, I try not to wrap, you know, the one before that, you know, fibers, you know. Okay, apparently this one's short, but I chose this on purpose because, you know, if you find a really long one, that's fine, but if you got only shorter one, I can just add one more here. I think this is Roseanne Cash. He is singing, you know, her father's song. Ha, I didn't even cut the tip. Okay, next, this is kind of little technique, maybe a trick. I'm going to kind of wobble, try to make a zigzag. Between and among here, you know, fibers here, fibers of aftershaft, so that I don't trap as less as I can. There you go. This definitely adds little weight and then protection of this. There you go. I got one more. There. Just about here. Which is usually about a two hookai lengths. One, two hookai. That's where you want to stop. There you go. Okay, then this is kind of, I think this is what's called a baby marabou, you know. Then all I need is this tip just about here. Well, let me show you a better one here. This one's better. This is looks like almost looks like a, you know, bigger version of this Chickabou. This is definitely good for tail of, you know, kind of streamer type. Here you go, here's the example I'm saying. See, here's the aftershaft. Definitely you can use this. I saved this on my little bucket here. So this will be the kind of wing. Just about this, just about length, just about right. As it may, I want to make a nice little head here. Yeah, this is just about right length. You could go a bit shorter. Okay. So this is a Spring Creek or Ponsan Lakes. If you want to fish with this indicator, definitely you use, you know, split shot to get it, you know, deeper to get the depths, and also, you know, most likely trailed with, you know, another bead head, you know, or weighted nymphs, you know, and then if you use probably intermediate line, you know, a sinking line, sink tips, then you may not, with a short butt leader, you know, then probably you may not need a split shot, you know, and then just let it sink and then do a finite a retrieve, or, you know, kind of stop and pause, stop and tease, you know, jigging, you know, kind of. Then this soft damsel will, you know, very fishy, you know, when it will get wet, it looks really good. So as you saw, this is a really simple fly to tie. So tie some and then let me know how it fishes. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day.